Hey everybody, today we're going to take a quick look at Bloodshot. This was directed by Dave Wilson and stars Vin Diesel, Isa Gonzalez, and Guy Pearce. Diesel plays Ray Garrison, a soldier who we initially see rescuing hostages in Mombasa. But after that mission, he and his wife are captured by some terrorists who are not very happy about him rescuing those hostages, and both of them are killed. But it turns out Garrison was only mostly dead, and he is resurrected by Dr. Emil Harding, played by Guy Pearce, and his brand new nanite technology. This turns him into a cyborg and not only makes him damn near invincible, but also allows him to hack into virtually any kind of computer system. And using these newfound abilities and his new allies, he goes out to get revenge on his wife's killer. So first, let me give you a little bit of an idea of where I'm coming from as I go into this movie. I know jack shit about Valiant comics. I've never read anything from Valiant, and all I know about Bloodshot is what I skimmed on the Wikipedia page. All I knew about this movie going in is it's based on one of Valiant comics' characters, and it's basically their attempt at launching a Valiant cinematic universe. I guess they saw what DC and Marvel were doing and thought, hey, why not us? Well, I'll tell you why. Bloodshot. I wouldn't say this is a bad movie. It's okay, but just okay is not what you should be going for when you're trying to start a new cinematic universe. Iron Man, this ain't. It ain't even Man of Steel. Now, to be fair, it's also not The Mummy, so they have that going for them. It's nowhere near as bad as The Mummy. But it does have some problems, and one of those problems is actually a problem that The Mummy had, after I just got done saying it's not The Mummy. Of course. But anyway, Vin Diesel. I like Vin Diesel in certain roles. Not so much this one, and the biggest problem here is this really seems like a role that should be played by someone not in his 50s. Much like Tom Cruise, he's aged well, he's definitely aged well, but he's still aged, and he still looks like he's aged, and this character just seems like it should be a younger man. And we never really get a sense of why Vin Diesel's character, Ray Garrison, was worth resurrecting in the first place. We get little bits and pieces of his past here and there, although it's questionable how accurate those visions are, because without going into spoilers, there's a bit of an unreliable narrator thing going on here. And so why was he chosen to be resurrected? Was he actually like some kind of super soldier, or was he just in the right place at the right time? It's possible they were trying to save something for the sequel, assuming there is a sequel, but you gotta give us something, and they really didn't. And the story, honestly, didn't do all that much for me. It's not bad, again, it's fine, but that's it, it's just fine. And based on what I've read about the comics, Bloodshot was originally used for military operations, which seems like a much more worthwhile use of his abilities. And in the movie, he's used to take out some corporate douchebag's rivals. And that's it. It's hard to say more than that without going into spoilers, but it just really didn't grab me. Some of the characters were kind of interesting. I did like Gonzalez's character, KT, who has some kind of a cybernetic implant that allows her to breathe in pretty much any environment. Any kind of toxic gas is no problem for her. The only downside is it's entirely controlled by Dr. Harding, and with the push of a button, suddenly she can't breathe at all. So she's basically sold herself into slavery. And I will say, Pierce makes a pretty good sleazy businessman. That guy is just rotten. As for the action sequences, there's some good and some bad. I did like the big elevator fight towards the end. That was fun. But one of the major action set pieces really did not work well for me. So Bloodshot hijacks a flower truck, F-L-O-U-R, and crashes it in a tunnel to block the bad guys from escaping, and when he does, the entire tunnel just fills with this flowery haze. And the flower acts like a giant smoke bomb that conceals Bloodshot's movements during the fight, so the bad guys can't see him coming. And I will give it this, I've never seen that before. But really, it's just a way to conceal the fact that we're just watching a bunch of stunt doubles fight. And the fight is not choreographed very well. All of the bad guys have guns, and it seems like there are several moments where they have the opportunity to use them, but for some reason they don't. And it's never really clear how many bad guys there are, because I swear they keep multiplying during the fight. They only had like two or three SUVs, and somehow there's fucking 20 of them. Just the whole scene is not put together very well. The movie does have one bright spot, and that is Lamorne Morris as Wilfred Wiggins. He basically becomes Bloodshot's guy in the chair, as well as the movie's comic relief, and I really did like this character. The movie was so much better once he showed up. So this is the part where I would tell you it's probably not worth going out to see this movie in theaters, but that's not really a problem now, so... oh well. It might be worth a rental, but that's about it. It's okay, but it's nothing special. And that's all I have to say about Bloodshot. Till next time, take care.